Breakthrough technology turns windows into solar panels. See-through solar panels that look like glass aren't just a pipe dream. They're already being used and have huge potential to help meet the world's energy needs from renewable sources. Transparent solar panels look like clear glass and let light through like regular windows. But they're made with a type of solar glass that absorbs ultraviolet and infrared light, which are types of light that aren't visible to the naked eye, and turn these into renewable electricity. The team of researchers at Michigan State University believe that solar windows and related transparent solar technologies could provide around 40% of energy the demand in the United States, and combined with rooftop solar units, this could rise to almost 100%. There's so much glass in the world, meaning the potential is huge. For example, the U.S. alone is estimated to have between 5 and 7 billion square meters of glass surface. Skyscrapers, for example, generally have a massive glass surface, which has potential for buildings like these to generate an enormous amount of clean, renewable energy from the sun. The U.S. solar window specialist company, called Ubiquitous Energy, says it plans to turn skyscrapers into vertical solar farms by installing these solar panel windows. The California-based company expects to start manufacturing floor-to-ceiling, transparent solar windows for buildings at high volume in 2024. Ubiquitous Energy was co-founded by Richard Lunt, a chemical engineer who led the development of transparent solar cells at Michigan State University. Researchers at Massachusetts Institute of Technology in the U.S. have also been developing transparent solar cells for many years. Meanwhile, solar windows are also taking off in Europe. A Netherlands-based company called Fizzy says it is installing 15,000 of its smart windows in office buildings across Europe. These are windows that contain both power-generating solar cells and sensor technology that helps manage the building's energy use and comfort. The windows will cut building energy costs by up to 30%. Transparent solar panels are already in use at Copenhagen International School in Denmark, resulting in the building being covered in 12,000 huge but clear solar panels. These provide 200 megawatts of electricity per year, which is more than half the energy that the building consumes. A key advantage of solar glass, also known as photovoltaic glass, is that it takes up less space than traditional solar panels. In cities with lots of buildings and limited space, setting up traditional solar panel installations is difficult, but transparent solar panels can be widely fitted even in cramped cities, helping buildings and cities meet net zero climate goals. In fact, nearly every surface of a building or landscape could be turned into a solar array to generate power. Breakthrough design for solar system laser in space. A new design for a solar system laser that is powered by sunlight has been unveiled by researchers in Algeria and Portugal. The solar laser is predicted to operate at a higher efficiency than existing systems and could have numerous applications, including a spaceborne system for harvesting solar energy for use on Earth. The concept of sunlight as a pumping source for producing laser light has been explored since the 1960s. Current technologies can be used to produce cost-effective laser systems with high power and brightness. Numerous advances in solar lasers have been made over the past decade, but current designs are limited by their use of a single large laser rod. This rod is the gain material that produces laser light through energy it acquires from the pump source. Single-rod solar systems tend to be expensive and suffer from uneven temperature distributions within the rod, which diminishes the quality of the beam it produces. The researchers did numerical simulations to help them design a more optimal solar laser setup. Their proposed system would operate in the TEM0 to 0 optical mode, which is the fundamental, lowest-order laser mode, where the intensity of light surrounding the center of the beam follows a simple Gaussian distribution. The team's design collects sunlight using 4 parabolic mirrors with a total area of 10 meters squared. Once this light has been harvested, it is directed to a laser head where it's distributed evenly between 4 fused silica concentrators and light guides. Finally, the light is used to simultaneously pump 4 small diameter laser rods, with the setup ensuring that pump power is distributed evenly between the rods. As a result, the design avoids the limitations presented by thermal lensing, which is an unwanted result where temperature irregularities in an optical material affects the paths taken by light. Altogether, the research team calculated that their alterations doubled the light collection efficiency of solar lasers operating in the TEM0 to 0 mode, resulting in 1.24 times more sunlight to laser conversion efficiency than previous designs. The researchers envisage numerous potential applications for their design, including better methods for monitoring the Earth's surface and atmosphere using satellites, along with the removal of space debris and deep space communications. Perhaps the most fascinating application is the development of new forms of solar energy production. The researchers propose that solar lasers could operate in space, where sunlight is around twice as strong as it is on Earth. Laser beams could be fired back to Earth and collected by concentrated solar cells in a process that is more efficient than ground-based solar energy collection. New inverted perovskite solar cell with a novel electron-accepting interlayer. A Korean research group has built an inverted perovskite cell that is able to retain 91.7% of its initial efficiency after 1,000 hours under standard illumination conditions. They built the device with an electron-accepting interlayer that also acts as charge transport. The researchers from the Korea University fabricated the inverted perovskite solar cell by introducing an electron-accepting interlayer at the interface between the perovskite layer and the electron transport layer. The cell has a pin structure, meaning the perovskite cell material is deposited onto the hole transport layer, then coated with the electron transport layer, which is opposite to conventional NAP device architecture. Inverted perovskite solar cells typically show strong stability, but have lagged behind conventional devices in terms of conversion efficiency and cell performance. The academics measured the performance of the device under standard illumination conditions and found it achieved a power conversion efficiency of 22.31%, an open circuit voltage of 1.16 volts, a short circuit current of 23.81 milliamps per centimeter squared, and a fill factor of 80.7%. A reference device without the PDI-SiB interlayer reached an efficiency of 19.98%, an open circuit voltage of 1.1 volts, a short circuit current of 22.86 milliamps per centimeter squared, and a fill factor of 78.74%. They introduced the cell technology in the paper Electron-Accepting PDI-SiB Interlayer for over 22% inverted perovskite solar cells with photo and thermal stability, which was recently published in RL Solar. Opto-electro thermal model to predict solar cell temperature output. Researchers from France's Institute of Nanotechnology's Lyon, INL, have developed a fully coupled opto-electro thermal model to predict the output and temperature of crystalline solar cells. They show the potential of the model to study the influence of the cell design on its real operating performance, thus giving a new opportunity for silicon solar cell optimization. For instance, the doping level is found to impact both the operating temperature and the temperature coefficient, showing that two cells with the same efficiency in standard test conditions can have a very different efficiency under real operating conditions. The scientists used COMSOL multiphysics software, which purportedly solves the complete Maxwell equations, as well as the carrier transport equations, while also offering a detailed thermal model, including all the main self-heating processes occurring in a solar cell. Detailed input sets are used for all physical modules, such as a temperature-dependent complex refractive index of CSI, which is found to be crucial for accurate simulation results. Radiative and convective cooling are also implemented. The research team compared different coupling scenarios on a benchmark crystalline silicon cell. These two steps are repeated until the absolute temperature difference between two iterations is smaller than a target value, which was 0.05 Celsius in this work. In the first iteration, a constant temperature distribution is used for the optical calculation. The model showed that two solar cells with the same power conversion efficiency rate under standard illumination conditions can achieve different efficiencies under real operating conditions depending on the doping level of the cells. The underlying reason was found to be twofold. 1. Different cell temperatures due to different thermal emissivities. 2. Different temperature coefficients attributed to the increase in open circuit voltage with the doping level. The study shed light on the dependence of the temperature coefficient on the solar spectrum. They presented the new model in a fully coupled opto-electro thermal model to investigate silicon solar cells under real operating conditions, which was recently published in EPJ Photovoltaics. This work opens the way to more reliable outdoor prediction. In another report published last year, the same research group proposed the use of PF radiative sky cooling at the research level as a potential passive cooling technique for buildings and solar modules. The group claimed the method could improve performance by more than 5 watts per square meter.